بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب زدني علما.
So the first thing we'll try to understand about the data plane. Now data plane refers to a specific component, or we can say the data plane is majorly responsible for forwarding the traffic. So it's responsible for forwarding the traffic. Like if you take a simple example of your router. Now let's say I'm trying to send a packet from 192.168.1.1, and maybe I'm destined to this 192.168.5. network. Now the packet reaches the router. Now once it reaches the router receives it, and it is going to process it. Process is nothing but checking the routing table and then figuring out the exit path or the exit interface. And according to the routing table, it is going to forward the packet. Right? So you can say forward the packet or the data, or if it is done in the network, in the LAN, generally we call as frame. You can use any name, or you can say message, whatever it is. Like in the same way, switches also, whenever you are trying to send any packet, generally the traffic is moving, and that particular device is responsible for forwarding out of a specific interface, depending upon whether it is based on the L3 address. In case of routing, in case of switches, it will see the MAC addresses and forward it. So that's something what we refer to the data plane. So data plane refers to the actual forwarding of your packet from one interface to another interface. It is also referred as a forwarding plane. So forwarding plane, that's another name we can say. Now there are different types of traffics includes, like it can be general IP traffic, which contains an IP packet and checks the IP addresses and forward the packet, or it can be a non-IP packets. Now non-IP packets means it can be like MAC addresses. Like the switches check the MAC addresses to forward the packet out of specific interface, or routing tables, because the routing tables has to be built to forward, right? So the router is going to check the routing table and forward the packet based on the IP, or even we can say a specific interface connecting to that, or specific cable, or when the packets are inside the router, it does some kind of queuing, buffering kind of thing. So these all individual tasks, we can say these are specific to data plane traffic or data plane job. Now again, for the data plane to work, the control plane should be functional. Again, we'll talk about control plane probably in the next topic. Control plane is nothing but it is responsible for building the routing table or building the database. And based on that information, it is going to forward. So the data plane is going to forward the traffic or forward the packets, but that is only possible when you configure some routing protocol. Let's take an example, routing. When you configure the routing protocol and you have a route inside the routing table, and that is something done by the control plane. So control plane learns the information, whereas the data plane is using that information to forward the packets. So let's see some of the common examples with respect to data plane. Like you can compare, like one example is when you are sending a packet in your switch network, the switch is going to identify the MAC address, and according to that MAC address, it is going to forward out of specific port. That is one kind of data plane task. And another, it can be like when the packet is moving between the switches, you do have some kind of trunk links configured, and it is going to do some kind of tagging and then forward it from switch to switch, or maybe switch to router if you're using sub interfaces for inter-LAN routing. That is one more example in the LAN, the common task. Now when it comes to WAN, again, when the packet is moving from the LAN, when it is moving to the router, the format will change. Again, the router, this is one, of course, this, it will change the format. That is called encapsulating and decapsulating the packet from layer 2 to layer 3, because it is moving from switch to router network. And once it reaches the router network, the router is going to check the routing table, and based on the routing table, it is going to forward. That is again forwarding the packet to the next interface. And while it is forwarding, let's say the router forwards to the next router, and that router receives and maybe there is an ACL applied on that particular interface, which is going to filter your traffic. That is again one more common example of the data plane. And again, one more thing, if you're using NAT, if you're connecting to some internet here and you need to convert this to public IP addresses by using something called NAT, that is again another example where your source or destination IPs can be changed as they go, especially when you're doing the NAT. Or if you're using some kind of VPNs, probably you encrypt the traffic. If you're setting up over internet some kind of VPN, then probably like IPsec VPN, like you can say encrypting your traffic so that it should not be seen by anyone. That is also an example of your data plane task. Now, these are some of the common tasks, generally what we see in our networks. There are plenty more, but data plane in simple, we can say that anything the device is going to forward, the forwarding task comes under the data plane.